It was crazy because I actually grew up watching the show. Like, I was serious into watching the show. Like, I used to be late to school. I had pajamas and underwear with the White Ranger on them. Like, Jason David Frank was my guy. Like, that was my hero growing up. So to get this role, it put me over the moon. Well, the show's basically about a group of kids who come across these dino gems, and it kind of transforms them into superheroes. So basically, with every episode, they're saving the world.
Check this out. I wrote a program. Generates a code.
So the sprinklers go off at different times every day.
Ethan James, he's, to put it simple, a giant nerd, computer geek, loves video games, and a pretty easygoing guy.
Welcome to my world. What do you think?
Yeah, I guess it's kind of cool in a techno, retro, dorky sort of way.
You can do anything here. Game, chat online, listen to music, eat, drink.
Well, I'm already kind of a nerd. I love video games myself, so I kind of just brought a little part of me into the character from that aspect. And what did I take away from it? He made me a lot more relaxed, because usually I was uptight, and just doing that character for so long, I kind of took away that quality from him.
I know you three are from different worlds. I get it. But you're gonna have to work together, or this will never happen. This won't be easy. Nobody knows that better than I do. But you're gonna have to believe in yourselves, because I believe in you.
When you're working on something like that, and you're working so many hours, and it's so grueling, and you're all doing the same thing, and you're doing such a good job, it brings you closer, right? Because you don't expect yourself to be able to do it. You kind of doubt yourself going into it, but once you realize you can do it and you're doing it together, you just automatically form like a brotherhood.
Thanks for trusting me with your powers, guys.
It's only alone, don't forget that. And anything to help get our Zords back.
I just wish you could have felt what it was like. The power is amazing.
The Triassic power was always meant for you, Connor. All you had to do was trust in yourself. Then it was easy for others to trust in you too.
James was pretty much the leader of the crew, and he really was a leader on set. You know, we kind of followed his lead. He was a great dude. There would be times when it would be like really hot out, and you didn't want to do anything else. You know, you kind of wanted a break, but he would always lighten the mood. He was just that dude.
Listen, my name is Kira. Maybe you should write it on your hand or something so you can remember.
Emma's such a sweetheart. Actually, one of the first times I was out in New Zealand, she actually came over to my apartment and made dinner and kind of made me feel at home. And I thank her for that, because I was real nervous going out to a new place for the first time.
Dr. O, we may have a problem on our hands.
Let me guess, a 30-story version of that guy you were just fighting?
You've done this before, haven't you?
Once or twice. I'm sending the Dino Zords.
Getting to work with Jason David Frank, my childhood hero, that stands out for something I'll never forget. And just actually meeting him and finding out that he's such a cool dude, because you kind of have these preconceived notions of actors and people who are fake. You kind of think they'll be a certain way, but he's such a cool guy, man. He taught me a lot, actually. Being a Power Ranger for so many years, he just kind of made it easy on set.
Hey, I'm looking for Haley. I'm supposed to start work today.
She's around here somewhere. Haven't I seen you at Reefside?
Yeah, I just moved here last week. My name's Trent.
I'm Ethan. This is Kira.
Jeff was one of the first guys I met. We flew out from Toronto to New Zealand together, and we lived in the same building, so we were real close. And to this day, we're still close. Still talk all the time.
What a day. New bikes, new Zords.
New Ranger. Well, sort of new.
It was actually really long days. Like, I would get up 4 o'clock in the morning, pretty much 6 days a week, and we wouldn't finish on set till about 6 p.m., and then from there, we'd have to go into a recording studio and do the voice parts when we were in the costume. And we wouldn't finish that till about 9, 10 at night, and got to do it all over again. So there wasn't a lot of sleeping. But I did have a stunt double, and I gotta give him so much credit. They're so good, and what they do, they don't get enough credit. I felt bad for him, because, you know, he's Asian. His name is Koichi. And they would spray paint him brown every morning and put a wig on him. And it was so hot. Like, New Zealand is hot. So he's got to be wearing all these stuff with the wig and spray painted brown. I thought every morning I would just hug him. I'd be like, come here, Koichi. I felt so bad for him. It's similar to dancing. You know, you got to do this choreography, but you have to do it in a way where, you know, people enjoy watching it. And it's hard. It's not easy. These guys would come up with a routine on the spot, and they would be able to do it over and over again. Whereas me, I'm more of an actor than a fighter, you know, stunt court. So it would take me a while. I have to be watching them like, wow, you guys are amazing. You just make it look so easy. It means the world to me. You see how it makes me feel, right? Asking the question, I'm just grinning. Because I think back to my childhood and how I had, you know, Jason David Frank pajamas. I hope there's somebody out there who has Kevin pajamas now, you know? So it's awesome.